Hello children, welcome to another lesson for EVS. In the last class we started a new chapter which was being safe. Being safe, and you learned all about of the safety rules, all about the safety rules at home. How can you keep yourself safe at home, right? It was like not playing with the switches and plugs, not playing with matchsticks or fire, not playing with the pointed objects, not touching the hot things, right? And now today you will learn about how can you keep yourself safe outside home. When you are outside your home, you can be in the school. Okay, you can be in the school. So how can you keep yourself safe at the school, on the road, and when you play? Today you will learn about how can you keep yourself safe in the school, on road, and when you play. Before I start that, I want to tell you a little story about three boys. There were three boys, Sonu, Monu, and Tonu. All three of them were very, very, very naughty. They were very naughty and they would never listen to their parents. One day, this boy, Sonu, went to the market with his mother, and they were standing on one side of the road and they had to cross the road and go to the other side. And there was red light, red signal on the traffic lights. Mama said, "Sonu, don't cross the road. It is red light. Don't cross the road. Don't run on the road." Sonu said, "Don't worry, Mama. I'm a grown up boy now. I can do it myself." And he ran on the road. And then what happened? A car coming with the speed hit Sonu badly. He fell on the road and he got hurt. His forehead started bleeding. And he got stitches on the forehead. Oh, he was in the pain. He was badly hurt. And you know about Monu? He went to school. He saw two children standing on the stairs. What he did? He pushed two of them. He pushed two children on the standing on the stairs. They fell off and they got hurt. And in return, what those children did? They also push him on the stairs, and he also fell off and got hurt, and he also got stitches over the forehead. My God, all two brothers got stitches. And the third one, Tonu, you know what he did? He loved playing with his toys. He loved playing with all the toys. You know what he would do? After playing, he would leave all the toys on the floor only. He would never collect them and organize them and put them back. He would always leave them on the floor only. Then what happened? He was just coming with his drink in the hand, and he did not look on the floor, and he tripped over the toys and fell off badly. He also got stitches on the forehead. So all the three boys were badly hurt. Why? Because they were not trying to be safe. They were not following the safety rules. But I know you all are very good children, and I am going to teach you about all the safety rules which you have to follow. I'm sure you all will be following them religiously, right? Okay, so now I'll be telling you about all these things. Come on, let's read about it. First of all, I will brief you about the rules which you have to follow at school. Whenever you are at school, never push anyone. Never push anyone. Okay? When you push them, it is not good for them. It is not safe for them. They can get hurt badly. Okay? And never run in the corridor. And in school, like, you have pencil, you have compass, scale, all these things are pointed things and sharp things. So never play with them. Just use them nicely. and do not insert your pencil or any such things in your nose, eyes or ears, right? So okay, now let's read about them. Everybody will speak after me. Do not push anyone because it can hurt others. Let's repeat, because here are a few words which are new to you. Do not push anyone because it can hurt, H-U-R-T, hurt others. How do you read this word? Others, O-T-H-E-R-S, others. Do not run in the corridor. Do not run in the corridor. Do not bring or use sharp objects. Do not bring and do not use sharp objects. Do not insert pencil or any other. Insert means to put something inside. Do not insert pencil or any other objects into your nose, ears, mouth or eyes. Object means things. Insert means to put inside. So it is all about this. Do not push anyone. Do not run in the corridor. Do not use sharp things. Do not insert pencil or any object in your nose whenever you are in the school. You must follow all these safety rules at the school, right? Okay, now let's move on. On the road. Have you ever seen these traffic lights on the road? I know you must have seen it. Yes. Now, there are three lights, red, yellow and green. What does red light tell us? When it is red light over here, what it means? It means you have to stop. You cannot move on, you have to stop. This yellow light means now you keep waiting. Now wait, wait and wait. And when it is the green light, you are ready to move. Okay, you can move freely. But whenever it is red light, remember, never jump red light. You have to stop and wait for the green signal. Even if your parents do it, you must stop them. Tell them, Mama, Papa, it is red light. So we have to wait here until it is green signal. Okay? So you must follow the traffic rules on the road. The first thing is, always follow the traffic rules on the road. And whenever you have to cross the road, cross at zebra crossing. See these white lines over the road? This is called zebra crossing. So you must cross over here only. Zebra crossing. And never run on the road. Do not run on the road. And if you are walking, then you must walk on the footpath only. If you have to walk, you must walk over the footpath only. Okay? Now let's read about them. When on road, follow traffic rules. Follow traffic rules. Cross road only with elders. Use footpath to walk. Use footpath to walk. Always cross at zebra crossing. Always cross at zebra crossing. Do not run on the road. I've already told you about this thing. Follow the traffic rules. And because you are very young children, so you must be accompanied with the elders or with the adults. Adults means the people who are grown up, okay, who can take care of you, who can look after you, who can guide you well. So always be with your elders or with any of the adults, okay, whenever you are to walk on the road. Next, when you play, after you finish playing, do not leave toys on the floor. Many a times I tell you that whenever you finish playing, you must rearrange your toys and never leave them on the floor. Someone may trip over them and fall. Hena? Okay. Turn the page. Next, do not play with sharp objects. When you have toys, make sure that you do not have any sharp object. Do not hurt anyone during games. When you are playing and if you are losing, don't start hitting or hurting someone. Okay? You should have a good spirit and never feel bad or or start hitting someone or start hurting someone. Okay? Do not hurt anyone during games. Do not play on the road. Yes, never play on the road. Many a times children go on the road and say, okay, let's play cricket here, let's play badminton here. Never play on the road. Anytime, any vehicle can be there on the road. Right? Okay, so this is about traffic light. I've already told you traffic light helps to control traffic. The red light says stop, yellow light says wait, green light says go. And you should cross the road only the walk signal is green. See, this is the walk signal. Look, this is the walk signal. When it is green, only then you have to move. So now let's wrap up the chapter. These are the safety rules which you must follow. At home, do not play with switch and fire. Do not let strangers enter your house. At school, do not run in corridor. Do not push anyone. Do not insert objects into your eyes, nose, mouth and ears. On road, always follow traffic rules. Use zebra crossing and footpath. And at play, do not play with the sharp objects. Do not hurt anyone. Alright, so you have learnt about all the safety rules and I'm sure you are going to follow all these rules and going to keep yourself absolutely safe from any kind of danger. Now, you have to read this complete chapter for today, okay? Read this chapter. Bye-bye, that's all for today. Keep learning, keep enjoying.